Hello everyone, this is Funny. You are watching Funny Teachers Info. Today I am going to talk about exposure limits, which means what is TLV, what is TWA, STEL, order threshold value, IDLH condition. Many people are exposed to variety of substances at work, example chemicals, fumes, dust, fibers, which can under some circumstances have a harmful effect on their health. These are called hazardous substances. If exposure to hazardous substances is not properly controlled, it may cause ill health in a number of ways. The substance may cause harm by too much being taken into the body through breathing, being absorbed through the skin, being swallowed, or acting directly on the body at the point of contact, example skin. Some illnesses are caused by exposure to hazardous substances in the workplace, may not appear until long time after the first exposure. Therefore, it is important to know in advance how to protect the health of the people working with hazardous substances and also of other people who may be affected by the work being carried out. As well as controlling exposure to substances hazardous to health, you need to be aware of that legal limits have been set on the amounts of many of the substances that can be present in the workplace air. These are known as workplace exposure limits. There are some major terms that you need to know that define the airborne concentration an individual may be exposed to over a given period of time. The first one, threshold limit value, TLV. This is also sometimes known as permissible exposure limit, PEL. However, the term PEL not used on the tankers these days. This is because the word permissible gives a feeling of allowed. Even though this is a safer limit, but we need to aim the minimum exposure of toxic vapors. Threshold seems to be a better word for that. TLV is the maximum concentration of toxic vapors that a person can be subjected to each day without any adverse health effects. Though there are three types of TLVs, a person working on the tankers or with chemicals should know at least two of these. The first one, TLV, TWA, threshold limit value, time weighted average. This is a concentration of toxic vapor that a person can be subjected to continuously for 8 hours in a day without any adverse health effect. This TLV, TWA takes into account the normal working schedule of 8 hours per day and 40 hours per week. Second one, TLV STEL, which means threshold limit value short-term exposure limit. This TLV STEL is the maximum concentration of toxic vapors that a person can be subjected to for a short duration of 15 minutes without any adverse health hazard. The minimum duration between subsequent exposure should be 60 minutes. The exposure cannot be more than 4 times in one day. Third one, order threshold value. This is the minimum concentration of toxic vapors at which a normal human being can sense the smell of the gas. Everyone working on the tankers or handling chemicals must be aware of exposure limits of the vapors released by the cargo on boats or storage places, and they should not enter any compartment which has the vapor concentration in the excess of these exposure limits. Next one, IDLH, immediate dangerous to life and health, is an exposure to airborne contaminants that is likely to cause death or immediate or delayed permanent adverse health effects or prevent escape from such an environment. And the ceiling limit. A ceiling limit is the concentration of limit of potentially harmful substances. The ceiling limits generally are maximum values that a person should avoid. Ceiling limits are the upper boundaries of harmful substances to which a person should not expose it to. For example, the ceiling limit of ammonia is 50 ppm. Different organizations use different terms of these exposure limits. Some of them are mentioned in this table. The first one, ACGIH, American Conference of Governmental Industrial Hygienists. The exposure guidelines are TLV-STEL, TLV ceiling value. AIHA, American Industrial Hygiene Association. The exposure guidelines are WHEEL and STEL. Next one, NIOSH, National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health. The exposure guidelines are REL and IDLH. And fourth one, OSHA, Occupational Safety and Health Administration. The exposure guidelines are PEL, which means permissible exposure limit. This is what TLV, STEL, IDLH and ceiling values. Thanks for watching.